Well, the burning question on many of your minds this morning, what should I eat for breakfast? Sarah Kosciusko is a pharmacist from Aspen Medical, and she's here with some healthy tips. She's also a certified diabetes educator. Thanks for being here today.
Thanks for having me.
You're very passionate about this topic. How does diabetes, insulin levels, how does that all fit into the breakfast conversation?
Okay, we'll start off talking a little bit about what is diabetes. Diabetes is when you don't have enough insulin to get the sugar out of your blood and to store it as glycogen, store it as fat. Insulin has a very, very important role in our body.
All right, so we need some insulin, but we don't want too much.
Right. If you have too much insulin in your body can become resistant to the insulin, one of the main causes of type 2 diabetes. Then your body can't do a good job of getting that sugar out of the blood. Also, if you've got too much insulin in your blood, you can't lose weight. Insulin directly inhibits lipase, which is a fat breakdown molecule, so you need to have a perfect balance of enough insulin to get the sugar out of your blood, to prevent diabetes, but also not too much so that you can keep at a healthy weight.
So are people getting a lot of sugar in their blood in the mornings because of what they're eating?
Yeah, you have lots of sugar in your blood in the morning for many reasons. Different hormones are released, but also just in general what we eat. Whenever we eat sugar, our blood sugars go up. Our body has to release insulin to prevent it. So if we're starting off in the morning eating sugar, for example, and I use the word sugar very loosely to mean anything that's a carbohydrate except for fiber.
Okay.
So we need to rethink what sugar is, which we'll talk about a little bit later. And also think about making sure that we're not having this big insulin release as soon as we wake up in the
morning. Okay, tell me a little bit more about that. I think you have a diagram that you're going to show us that makes a little bit more sense.
So when you wake up in the morning and the first thing you eat is sugar. So I use the word sugar for juice in this instance. Okay. You have a glass of juice. Your body takes very little work to absorb that juice. You get a big spike of blood sugar, and your body has to release insulin to control that blood sugar. So you get insulin released, let's say, to this level here. Your body has done such a good job of getting rid of that blood sugar that the insulin is actually around longer than it needs to be. The only way for your body to get rid of that insulin is to get you to eat again.
Okay.
So if you eat at 8 and you're hungry again at 10, it's usually not that you didn't eat enough, it's that you had too much sugar because your body's trying to get rid of the insulin, so you eat again, high blood sugar again.
So if you're eating more, obviously you're going to be gaining more weight.
Exactly. And if you have this high level of blood sugar in your body all day long because you're eating to control your insulin level, to bring your insulin level back down, then you're also going to, your pancreas is going to peter out, not going to be able to release insulin anymore. You're going to get insulin resistance, and it's impossible to lose weight with this much extra insulin in your system all the time, even if that insulin isn't working because it's damaged and resistant and all the things that happen with type 2 diabetes.
All from a glass of juice. Very interesting. Mm-hmm. We're going to continue this conversation as well as make it more practical about what types of foods you're eating, what types of drinks you're drinking in the morning, and how that applies to your breakfast routine. Stick around with us. Sarah's coming back. Welcome back. Ditch the diet, people. We're talking healthy, sustainable foods to get you going in the morning. Sarah Kosciusko, pharmacist and certified diabetes educator from Aspen Medical, joins us again. Thanks for being here.
Thanks.
Sarah, in the span of 3 meals of the day, how important is breakfast?
Breakfast is the most important meal of the day. You've got to think about every time you eat as fuel for your body. So you're starting your day, you want to fuel your body with good stuff. It's going to take you for the next 4 hours. Whereas supper, you're fueling yourself to sleep. You don't need a big supper. The old saying, eat breakfast like a king and supper like a pauper, is true, and we forget it, and people have been saying it for years.
Interesting. Let's take a look at one of the photos. I mean, I pulled some breakfast photos of some of the favorite things that people probably like. Let's go through this. Pancakes.
All carbohydrates, which is all sugar. In fact, I see a little bit of bacon on that paper, but everything else on that paper is sugar. Oh, except for the eggs.
The eggs are there, but there's toast on there, there's croissants.
Yeah. If it's made of grains or wheat or flour, it is sugar. Fruit is a sugar.
Yeah, so how does it work with fruit? Because I think there is a healthy component of fruit.
Mm-hmm. There's lots of really good vitamins in fruit, good fiber in fruit. Fruit is way better than fruit juice. If you eat a piece of fruit, I think of fruit juice as taking a lighter and trying to light a tree on fire. It's not going to light. If you take that tree, and this is from Rob Wolf, and you put that through a blender or wood chipper, you can light that. So taking juice, it makes your body just be able to absorb that sugar really quickly, high insulin response. That being said, fruit should be a treat. You can get all the nutrients from vegetables. Try to get out of your
vegetables
10
in the morning?
Fruits
Do the
and vegetables.
In the morning?
Yes. Start rethinking your breakfast. Don't think about breakfast as breakfast food. Think about it as supper food. Store your supper.
Eat leftovers?
Exactly.
Really?
Really.
And that would be a good start to your day. We'd get you going.
Yes, I can give you some more traditional breakfast foods, but really, rethink it. Eat your supper for breakfast.
Interesting. Let's take a look at picture number two. This one I thought was a little bit healthier. Sarah, let us know what you think. There's some oatmeal there. There's an egg and there's some yogurt. What do you think about that breakfast?
This is better, especially if that's a Greek yogurt. Greek yogurts are a great breakfast food, especially if you're getting one that it does not have a lot of sugar added. You could add a little bit of your own fresh fruit to it. Oatmeal, if it's slow cooked oatmeal, it's really high in fiber. That's really good. The instant oatmeals are the glycemic index, meaning how quickly it's the sugar is absorbed into your blood. Instant oatmeals are far worse for you than a slow-cooked oatmeal.
What about, like, I'm a cereal girl, and I always feel good about myself when I'm eating Cheerios or Special K.
I used to be the same way. Look at the nutrition label. It's all carbohydrate. It's all sugar. You can subtract the fiber from the total carbs, but in something like Special K and Cheerios, you're still going to be getting so much sugar, probably 30 grams of sugar with your breakfast. No protein, no fiber.
We'll just leave you with this last picture. We have breakfast number three just before we go. This one I think was probably the best. It has some eggs in there, protein, sausage, some beans in there. That looks like a better breakfast too.
So protein is so important, and I'm not going to discuss the fat right now, but the protein is so, so important for breakfast. It keeps you, releases satiating hormones. Protein, a lot of times when you're craving sugar, you're actually just craving protein, and your body can't distinguish between the two. So a good protein source with your breakfast.
Sarah, thank you for being here this morning. Go try it out, see if you feel better, and tweet us. Let us know. Thanks, Sarah, for
being
here.
Thanks, Molly.